गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर डूइंग वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स एंड इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ दिस वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स वी आर कमिंग टू द एक्सरसाइज 7.2. इन द बिगनिंग वी हैव मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस. आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इफ 1/3 ऑफ ए नंबर इज 10 लेस देन द नंबर original number, then the number is, when we find 1/3 of 30, it is 10, but 10 is 20 less than 30, so it is wrong answer. When we find 1/3 of 15, which is 5, and 5 is 10 less than 15, so 15 is our correct answer. So for first part, our correct answer is B. Come to part 2. Sum of the two numbers is 39 and their difference is 15. Then find the numbers. We have to find such two numbers which gives on addition 39 and on subtraction they gives 15. When we find the addition of 17 and 22, it is 39, so sum is 39, this is correct. But when we find the difference is only 5, not the 15, so it is wrong answer. Here clearly difference is 13, so this is also wrong answer. Here sum is 39, 27 plus 12, and difference is also 15, so our correct answer is C, 27, 12. Third question, the ratio of the two numbers is 2:5 and their difference is 63. The larger number is, first find out the ratio from difference from the ratio 5 minus 2, 3, divide 63 by 3, which is 21. Now you have to find the larger number ratio is 5. So multiply 5 by 21, we get 105. So our correct answer is option D, 105. Now moving to fourth, consecutive multiples. Consecutive means in continuation, one after the another. Consecutive multiples of 3, two multiples should be in continuation and multiples of 3 should be. And their sum should be 27. 23 is not a multiple of 3, so it is clearly wrong answer. 27 and 30 both are the multiple of 3. Both are consecutive also. 3 9 ja 27 9 times, and next is 3 10 ja 30. So in this way they are consecutive multiples having the difference 3. And their sum is 27 plus 30, 57. So our correct answer is option B, 27 and 30. Now come to question number 5. 5 times a number exceeds 60 by 5. Find the number. Let's see the solution. Suppose the number is x, its 5 times is 5x, and 60 less than 5x is 5, because number is 60 more than the original number. So 5x is equals to 60 plus 5 this times, so 5x is equals to 65. Then x is 65 divided by 5, which is 13. So our number is 13. This is a solution for question number 5. Now coming to question 6, the difference between a number and 2/3 of itself is 13. Find the number. Here we suppose one number x and its 2/3 2x upon 3, and then the difference of both is 13. x minus 2x upon 3 will be 13. Then by taking the LCM, we get 3x minus 2x upon 3 is equal to 13, x upon 3, 13. Then x will be 13 multiplied by 3, which is 39. So number is 39. Let us see the solution also. Suppose the number is x, 2/3 2x upon 3, and then when 2/3 is subtracted from the original number, we get 13 according to the question. So x minus 2x upon 3 is 13, and by taking LCM and subtracting, we get 1x upon 3 is equal to 13. Denominator 3 is then transposed to right hand side, we get, and it get multiplied, and then we have x is equals to 13 multiplied by 3, which is 39. So our number is 39. Moving to question 7, the sum of 3 consecutive odd numbers is 63. Consecutive, as earlier told to you, in continuation, one after the another, and their sum is 63. Find them. Because the numbers are odd, so we take first number 2x plus 1. This is the difference. Second number 2x plus 3, taking the difference of 2. And third is 2x plus 5. And then add all of them, their sum should be 63. Now let's go through the solution of question number 7. First number is supposed 2x plus 1, and the other two numbers are 2x plus 3 and 2x plus 5. Here it should be 5. Then sum of the three odd numbers, 2x plus 1 first, 2x plus 3 second, and 2x plus 5 third. Sum of all three odd numbers is given to us in the question, 63. And then 2x plus 2x plus 2x, that is 6x, and 1, 3 and 5 get subtracted on being transposed towards right hand side. So we get 63 minus 1 minus 3 minus 5, which is 54. Then x is 54 divided by 6, 9. So x is not the final answer. Our answer is first number 2x plus 1. So we have to put the value of x here. 2 9 18 plus 1 19. So 19 is the first odd number, and next odd number plus 2 21, and then after that the third odd number 21 plus 2 23. So the three odd numbers are 19, 21 and 23. When you add all these three odd numbers, your sum will be 63. This will verify your solution. Coming to question number 8. In a class of 52 students, the number of boys is 6 upon 7 times of the number of girls. How many are the boys? First, number of girl is not given here. Number of boys is given, 6 by 7 of girls. So we will begin by supposing the number of girls as x. Number of boys will be 6x upon 7. And then their total sum is equal to the total students. X plus 6x upon 7 is equal to 52, and that will be the equation. Then we will solve the equation and find out the x, and now go through the solution. Suppose the number of girls is x, then number of boys 6 by 7 times of girls, so 6x upon 7, total students 52, the girls plus boys, x plus 6x upon 7 is 52. Multiply both sides by 7. 7 is the LCM of 1 and 7 here. Then we get here 7x, and here only 6x, and here 52 multiplied by 7 is 364. then we get 13x 364, and x is 364 upon 13, which is 28. It means that number of the girls is 28 and the number of the boys is 6 upon 7 of 28, 7 4 that 28, 4 into 6, 24. And further we can check our answer, verify by answer, by adding 28 and 24. When you add both of them, their sum should be 52. Here we add 28 and 24, its sum is 52, and this verifies our answer. Moving to question number 9. A man bought a book for rupees 15. Twice the amount left with him is 70. How much money did he have? Whatever is asked to us and whatever is unknown in the question, we will begin from there. We will suppose that quantity as x. We will suppose that the money in the beginning the man had have rupees x, and then go to the solution for question number 9. Suppose original amount is rupees x, price of book rupees 15 given in the question, and then after purchasing the book the money left with him is x minus 15, and it is given in the question that twice the money left with him is equal to 70. So 2 into x minus 15 is 70, and then this is the equation formed here. Now equation is solved by dividing both sides by 2. First step, x minus 15 is 70 by 2, 35. Then minus 15 is transposed to right side. X is equal to 35 plus 15, 50. It means in the beginning the man had rupees 50. Anita's mother, this is question 10 now, is 4 times as old as Anita. We begin from here. Let's suppose Anita's present age x years, then Anita's mother's age 4x years. Then there is a condition 20 years later, so we will add 20 in both the ages, Anita's age as well as mother's age. And then we will relate, and it a relation given to us is that she will be just twice as old as Anita. Mother will be 2 times of the age of Anita after 20 years. We have to find their present ages. Coming to the solution, suppose Anita's present age x, mother's 4 times of x, 4x, and then Anita's age after 20 years x plus 20, and mother's age 4x plus 20, and relation is 4x plus 20 is 2 times of x plus 20, mother's age is twice the Anita's age after 20 years. This forms the equation. Now solution of the equation, 2x is transposed to left side, 20 transposed to right side, 4x minus 2x, 2x, 40 minus 20, 20. 2x 20 means x is 10, means Anita's present age is 10 years. And if it is asked in the question that mother's present age, and that is 4 times of Anita's age, means 4 into 10, 40 years. But here only Anita's present age is asked to us, so it is 10 years. Moving to question 11. The last one. After 15 years later, a man will be 2 times as old as he was 15 years ago. How old is he now? Here also we begin with supposing the present age of the man as X, then we write his age 15 years later and 15 year ago. 15 later his age will be X plus 15, and 15 years ago his age was X minus 15, and then we will relate both the ages, form equation and solve the equation. Come to the solution. Suppose present age X, after 15 years X plus 15, age before 15 years X minus 15. Relation is that age after 15 years is twice the age 15 years before, and then 2 is multiplied, equation is simplified, X plus 15 equal to 2X minus 30, then 2X is transposed to right left side, 15 transposed to right side. We get minus X here, X minus 2X, and minus 30, minus 50, minus 45. Minus sign will get cancelled from both the sides. When we have left with X equal to 45, it means man's age was 45. We can check our answer. After 15 years, his age will be 60, 45 plus 15. And before 15 years, his age was 45 minus 15, 30. And 60 is twice of 30, so our answer is correct. I hope that you have understood all these questions. You have to try all these questions yourselves. Thanks to every one of you. Okay.